Dear students, welcome to eShikshana program. In my last couple of classes, I discussed and solved problems on discrete and continuous random variables. The next topic is probability distributions. There are two types of probability distributions. One is discrete probability distribution and another one is continuous probability distribution. So to begin with, let me start discrete probability distributions, in particular binomial probability distributions. Binomial probability distribution is a discrete probability distribution. So before we define what is binomial distribution, let me tell you about binomial Bernoulli trial. A trial is said to be Bernoulli if it satisfies the following conditions. The trial must result either in success or failure. The probability of success or failure remains constant for any trial. Now, let me define binomial distribution. Let there be n independent trials in an experiment. Let a random variable x denote number of success in these n trials. Let p be the probability of success and q that of failure in a single trial, so that p plus q is equal to 1. Let the trials be independent and p or q be constant for every trial. Let us now find the probability of r successes in n trials. R successes in n trials can be obtained in NCR ways. Therefore, probability of r successes, that is x is equal to r, can be written as NCR times probability of success r times into failure n minus r times. So these are all independent events. So therefore, this can be written as NCR into probability of success into probability of success r times into probability of failure n minus r times. So if you consider probability of success by p and probability of failure by q, then NCR into p into p etc p r times and q into q into q into q n minus r times. Therefore, probability of r successes in n trials can be written as NCR p power r, because p multiplied r times, so p power r, q is multiplied n minus r times, so q power n minus r, where r varies from 0, 1, 2, etc. up to n. So this is called the binomial probability distribution of the random variable x, and x is called the binomial variate. Note 1. The successive probabilities in 1 for r is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 up to n are q power n. When r is 0, nc naught p power 0 into q power n. So you get q power n. When r is 1, nc 1. When r is 1, x is equal to 1, that is r is 1, nc 1, p power 1, q power n minus 1, nc 1, q power n minus 1 into p power 1. Similarly, when r is 2, you get nc 2, q power n minus 2, p square. When r is 3, nc 3, q power n minus 3 into p cube, etc. ncr, q power n minus r, p power r, when r is r itself, etc. When r is n, ncn is 1, p power n, q power n minus n, that is 1. So you get p power n, p power n. These are nothing but the successive terms of the binomial expansion of q plus p power n. So when we expand this binomially, the successive terms are nothing but these terms. So for this reason, this distribution is called binomial distribution. Note 2. N and p occurring in the binomial distribution 1. N and p occurring in the binomial distribution 1 are called the parameters of the distribution. So when n and p are known, we can construct the binomial distribution ncr p power r q power n minus r, which is nothing but which gives the probability of r successes in n trials, r ranging from 1 to n. So mean and variance of binomial distribution. So we know that probability of r successes in n trials, p of x is equal to r, is ncr p power r q power n minus r. Or pr is equal to, for simplicity we write simply, p of r is equal to ncr p power r q power n minus r, x is equal to r. The definition of mean e of x is sigma x px, or here x is equal to r, sigma r pr, where r varies from 0 to n. So pr is ncr p power r q power n minus r, so that has to be substituted for p of r here. So when we expand this summation, we get, when r is 0, so 0 into this, so 0, plus when r is 1, 1 into nc1 p power 1, that is p q power n minus 1, plus when r is 2, 2 into nc2 p square q power n minus 2, when r is 3, 3 nc3 p cube q power n minus 3, etc., etc. When r is n, n into ncn p power n q power n minus n. So when we simplify this, nc1 is n p into q power n minus 1 plus 2, nc2 is n into n minus 1 by factorial 2 into p square q power n minus 2 plus 3, nc3 is n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 divided by factorial 3 p cube q power n minus 3, etc., etc. Ncn is 1, so n into p power n q power 0, that is 1, so n into p power n. So in this, np is multiplied to all the terms, so we can remove this as a common factor and conveniently, and can simplify the terms here. So 2 2 gets cancelled here, and factorial 3 is 6, so you get a factorial 2 here. So if you do these simplifications and remove n into p outside, so we get n into p q power n minus 1, n into p q power n minus 1. So here also n into p is taken outside, this 2 2 will get cancelled, so n minus 1 into p into q power n minus 2 n minus 1 into p into q power n minus 2, plus similarly next term, so this is factorial 2, 3 3 can cancel, so n into p, we have taken it outside, so n minus 1 into n minus 2 p square into q power n minus 3, n minus 1 into n minus 2 factorial 2 p square into q power n minus 3, plus etc., etc. The last term n into p power n, so if you take n into p outside, this is p power n minus 1 p power n minus 1. So from here to here is nothing but the binomial expansion of q plus p power n minus 1. Since q plus p is equal to 1, so n into p into 1, so np. So mean of the binomial distribution is n into p. This has to be remembered. Binomial, mean of the binomial distribution is n into p. Variance of binomial distribution. Sigma square is equal to Ex square, the same old definition what we considered in the last few classes, Ex square minus E of x the whole square. So E of x is mean, already we have determined this, this is n into p, so only thing we need to find out, what is E of x square. So E of x square is sigma r from 0 to n r square pr. So write r square as r plus r into r minus 1. So if you simplify, that is add and subtract r. So when you simplify, r plus r square minus r plus r get cancelled, you get back r square into pr. Okay, so multiply pr to each of the term and separate the summations. So sigma r from 0 to n r into pr plus sigma r from 0 to 1 r into r minus 1 into pr. So this is nothing but the mean of the binomial probability distribution, that is E of x. So this is E of x is plus sigma r from 0 to n r into r minus 1. Substitute for pr, ncr p power r q power n minus r from 1. So E of x, we got n into p. So substitute for E of x, plus when r is 0, first term is 0. When r is 1, second term also 0. When r is 2, 2 into 2 minus, that is 2 into 1, nc 2, p square, r is 2, q power n minus 2, plus when r is 3, 3 into 3 minus 1, 3 into 2, nc 3, p cube, q power n minus 3, etc., etc. When r is n, n into n minus 1, nc n, p power n, q power 0, that is n minus n. So n into p plus, if you simplify this, 2 into nc2, 2 into 1, 2, nc2 is n into n minus 1 by factorial 2, p square, q power n minus 2, plus 3 into 2, n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 by factorial 3, into p cube, q power n minus 3, etc., etc., n into n minus 1, ncn is 1, so p power n into q power 0 is 1. So let us simplify this. 2, 2 we can cancel here. And this is 6, factorial 3 is also 6. So this can be written as factorial 1, cancelling out this 6. And you can easily observe that n into n minus 1 into p square is multiplied to all the terms. So let us take n into n minus 1 p square as a common factor and write this as q power n minus 2, that is the leading term of n into n minus 1 p square as a common factor. This is cancelled. You are left with q power n minus 2, q power n minus 2. Then similarly, n into n minus 1 p square is, we have taken it out. So we are left with n minus 2 into p, that is n minus 2 by factorial 1, into p into q power n minus 3, n minus 2 into p q power n minus 3, etc., etc. So from the last term, n into n minus 1 p square into p power n minus 2, so you are left with p power n minus 2. This is nothing but the binomial expansion of q plus p raised to the power n minus 2. So since q plus p is equal to 1, we are left with E of x square is equal to n into p plus n into n minus 1 p square into 1. So therefore, variance is equal to ex square minus ex the whole square. So ex square is n into p plus n into n minus 1 p square minus ex the whole square. Ex is np, so np whole square. So if you simplify n into p, so this is n square into p square minus n into p square minus n square p square. So plus n square p square minus n square p square, that will get cancelled. So from these two terms, you can take np common factor, np into 1 minus p. 1 minus p is q, so therefore this is equal to npq. So variance is npq, mean is n into p. So therefore standard deviation is square root of variance root of npq. So these three have to be remembered because in problems we are directly considering the standard deviation as root npq, variance npq, and mean np. So these has to, these three formulas need to be remembered. Okay. Now let us consider the problems. So in this problem, the mean and standard deviation of a binomial variate x with parameters np So n and p are the parameters of binomial distribution. The mean and standard deviation of a binomial variate x with parameters np are 6 and root 2. That means mean is 6, standard deviation is root 2. So just now we derived standard deviation root np cube and mean e of x is n into p. So mean is 6, that is n into p is 6, standard deviation is root 2, that is root npq is root 2. Find the distribution function, that is we need to find what is p of x is equal to r. Further, find the probability of x is exactly equal to 3 and the probability of x greater than or equal to 3. Got it. So we need to calculate first the two parameters involved in binomial distribution, n and p. That means we need to find n and p. So what is given? Mean is equal to 6. That is np is equal to 6. Mean is 6 means np is equal to 6. Standard deviation is root 2. Standard deviation of binomial distribution is root npq. So root npq is equal to root 2. So when you square both sides, you get variance. That is npq is equal to 2. So using np is equal to 6, here you can find the value of q. So q is equal to 2 divided by np. So np is 6, 2 by 6 is 1 by 3. Once q is known, since 1 plus p is equal to 1 plus p plus q is equal to 1, so p is equal to the complement of q. So p is 1 minus q. So this is equal to 1 minus q is 1 by 3. So 3 minus 1, 2 by 3. Therefore, so p, one of the parameter we have determined, but we need to determine another parameter n. So p is known, right hand side is 6, so you can easily find out what is n. N is equal to 6 by p. N is equal to 6 by p is equal to 6 into p is 2 by 3 or into 3 by 2. So 2 3 is, so you can cancel out this 2 and 6, so you get 3 here, 3 into 3, 9. So n is equal to 9. So probability, the PMF of binomial probability distribution is p of x is equal to r is equal to ncr p power r q power n minus r. So let us substitute the newly obtained values for n and p. Here we get the probability, binomial probability distribution for this problem as p of r is equal to 9cr into p. P is 2 by 3 power r into q power n minus r. So q is 1 by 3. So n is 9. So 9 minus r. The next problem. What is the probability of x is equal to 3? So probability of x is equal to 3 is nothing but probability of r is equal to 3, because x is equal to r. So replace r by 3 in this, r by 3, 9c3, 2 by 3 power r, r is equal to 3, 1 by 3 power 9 minus r, r is 3, 9 minus 3 is 6. So using calculator, if you calculate, this will be 0.0341. The next question, probability of x greater than or equal to 3 or probability of r greater than or equal to 3. So this can be written as complement as 1 minus p of r strictly less than 3. So this is equal to 1 minus probability of r less than 3. So we can go up till 0, 1 and 2. So the next immediate lower value of 3 is 2. So we have to stop at 2. So 1 minus p of 0 plus p of 1 plus p of 2. So 1 minus, the substitute r is equal to 0. In this case here, p of 0, 9c0, 2 by 3 power 0, 1 by 3 power 9. 1 by 3 power 9. Similarly, when r is 1, so 9c1, 2 by 3 power 1, 1 by 3 power 8, that is 9 minus 1. 9 minus 1, 8. And similarly, when r is 2, 9c2 plus 2 by 3 power r, the r is 2 here, 1 by 3 power 9 minus 2, that is 7. So when you calculate using calculator systematically, the answer is 0.9917. Therefore, the probability of x greater than or equal to 3 or probability of r greater than or equal to 3 is 0.9917. So let me consider second problem. The probability that a bomb dropped from a plane will strike the target is 1 by 5. If 6 bombs are dropped, find the probability that exactly 2 will strike the target. Second question, at least 2 will strike the target. Exactly 2, at least 2 will strike the target. So the problem is this. The probability that a bomb dropped from a plane will strike the target is 1 by 5. So probability of a bomb hitting the target or striking the target is given. So we can take this as the probability P is equal to 1 by 5. 6 bombs are dropped. So 6 bombs are dropped. So our N is 6. So we got N is equal to 6. We got P is equal to 1 by 5. So by using the relation 1 plus P plus Q is equal to 1, we can find Q as 1 minus 1 by 5. That is, we will calculate afterwards. Okay. So, in the solution part, let X be the random variable denoting the number of bombs that strike the target. Probability of a bomb striking the target is given to be 1 by 5. So we can take the probability P is equal to 1 by 5. So Q is equal to 1 minus P, because P plus Q is equal to 1. So therefore Q is 1 minus 1 by 5. 5 minus 1, that is 4 by 5. So we got the two parameters, P 1 by 5 and N is equal to 6. Another parameter, N is equal to 1 by 6. Therefore, we can construct the probability mass function PMF of binomial probability distribution as P of x is equal to r is equal to ncr into p power r q power n minus r. So substitute for n and p q, after substituting we get 6cr, p is 1 by 5 raised to the power r, q is 4 by 5, so 4 by 5, 6 minus r. Now the question is, next question, after constructing the probability mass function PMF of binomial distribution for this problem, we need to find the probability of exactly 2 will strike the target. That means r is equal to 2, r x is equal to 2. Probability of exactly 2 bombs will strike the target is P of r is equal to 2, r x is equal to 2, is nothing but replace r by 2 in this relation. We get 6c2 1 by 5 square into 4 by 5 raised to the power 6 minus 2, that is 4. So when you calculate using calculator, you get 0.245. so therefore probability of exactly 2 bombs striking the target is 0.245. the next problem, what is the probability that at least 2 will strike the target? Probability of at least 2 bombs will strike or hit the target is, so at least means 2 or more. So probability of r greater than or equal to 2 is equal to 1 minus its complement is 1 minus p of r less than 2 is equal to 1 minus p of 0. So we have to stop at 1, because we cannot include 2 here, strictly less than 2. So p of 0 plus p of 1. So p of 0, put r is equal to 0 in the probability mass function in this relation. Put r is equal to 0, here also 0, here also 0. Then 1, next term 6c1, 1 by 5 power 1, 4 by 5 power 6 minus 1, that is 5. Okay, so 6c0, 1 by 5 power 0, 4 by 5, 6 minus r 0, plus 6c1, 1 by 5 power r is 1, 4 by 5 power 6 minus r is 1, so 6 minus 1, that is 5. So using calculator, if we calculate, we get the answer as 0.344. So therefore, probability of at least two bombs striking the target or will hit the target is 0.344. So the next question is, out of 800 families with 5 children each, how many would you expect to have 3 boys, 5 girls, and either 2 boys or 3 boys? Assume equal probabilities for boys and girls. That means probability of boys and probability of girls are equal. That means they must be equal to 1 by 2 only, because they should make the sum is equal to 1. P plus Q is equal to 1. Okay. So the solution part. So let us assume probability of boy and probability of girl is equal, and they must be equal to 1 by 2, and n with 5 children. So n should be equal to 5. So we have the parameter P and another parameter N. So both the parameters P and N. So I can construct the probability mass function for binomial distribution for this problem as P of R is equal to 5CR. So replace N by 5, P by 1 by 2, Q by 1 by 2. So I get 5CR into 1 by 2 power R into 1 by 2 power 5 minus R. So these two can be simplified. So when you simplify, get P of R is equal to 5CR into 1 by 2 power R plus 5 minus R. R we can cancel, so you get 1 by 2 power 5. Now here the random variable is number of boys. The probability of 3 boys in a family of 5 children is, probability of R is equal to 3. That is equal to, substitute R is equal to 3 here. So 5C3, so this is constant, there is no R here. So 1 by 2 power 5, 1 by 2 power 5. When you simplify, you get 0.3125. So this is of one family. So the question is, out of 800 families with 5 children each, how many would you expect to have 3 boys? That means we have to multiply this probability to 800 families, then we get the approximate number of families having 3 boys. So therefore, out of 800 families, the expected number of families having 3 boys is equal to 0.3125 into 800, that is equal to exactly 250. So 250 families are expected to have 3 boys in a family of 5 children. Next, probability of 5 girls in a family. That means all the children girls, so no boys. That means R is equal to 0. No boys. The probability of 5 girls in a family of 5 children is, family of 5 children is, P of R is equal to 0, so no boys, is equal to, the substitute R is equal to 0 here, so P of 0, R is equal to 0, so 5C0, 1 by 2 power 5, 1 by 2 power 5, and when you simplify using calculator, when you calculate this value, it turns out to be 0.03125. So therefore, out of 800 families, the expected number of families having 5 girls, that is no boys, is equal to 800 into 0.03125, so that is 25. So 25 families are expected to have 5 girls in a family of 5 children each. Third problem. Either 2 boys or 3 boys. The probability of 2 boys or 3 boys in a family is probability of R is equal to 2 R plus 3 boys. Probability of R is equal to 3, that is equal to, when R is 2, you get 5C2, 1 by 2 power 5, plus when R is 3, 5C3, 1 by 2 whole power 5. So when you simplify this, you get 0.625, which is the probability of 2 boys or 3 boys in a family. Out of 800 families, therefore, out of 800 families, the expected number of families having either 2 boys or 3 girls is equal to 800 into this probability is equal to 500. So 500 families are expected to have 2 boys or 3 boys out of 5 children in each family. Next question. The probability of germination of a seed in a packet of seeds is found to be 0.7. So probability of germination of a seed is given to be 0.7. If 10 seeds are taken for experimenting on germination in a laboratory, find the probability that 8 seeds germinate, at least 8 seeds germinate, and at most 8 seeds germinate. So what is given here? The probability of a seed, probability of germination of a seed is 0.7. So that means probability P is 0.7, one of the parameter. If 10 seeds are taken, that means n is equal to 10. So we know both the parameters, n is 10 and p is 0.7. So therefore q is 1 minus 0.7 is equal to 0.3. So therefore you can easily construct the probability mass function of probability binomial probability distribution. Then after finding the probability mass function for the binomial distribution for this problem, we need to find probability that 8 seeds germinate, at least 8 seeds germinate, and at most 8 seeds germinate. So let the random variable x is equal to r be the number of seeds that germinate. Okay. So the solution part, probability of germination of a seed p is 0.7. So therefore q can be calculated as 1 minus p is equal to 0.3. and n is equal to 10, 10 seeds. Therefore, the probability mass function of binomial distribution is P of x is equal to r is equal to ncr p power r q power n minus r. The substitute for n is equal to 10, substitute for p is 0.7, substitute for q is 0.3. So P of rx is equal to r is 10 cr 0.7 power r, 0.3 power 10 minus r. So probability that 8 seeds germinate is probability of r is equal to 8. That means replace r by 8 in this expression. So 10c8, 0.7 power r is 8, into 0.3 power 10 minus r is 8. 10 minus 8 is 2. So when you simplify, you get the answer as 0.2334. So probability that 8 seeds germinate is 0.2334. Next, probability that at least 8 seeds germinate. Probability that at least 8 seeds means greater than or equal to 8. So P of R greater than or equal to 8 is equal to P of 8 plus P of 9 plus P of 10. So 10 seats. So 8, 9, 10. So P of 8, replace R by 8. So 10C8, 0.7 power 8, 0.3 power 10 minus 8 is 2, plus P9, 10C, replace R by 9 here, 0.7 power 9 into 0.3 power 10 minus 9, that is 1, 10, when R is 10, 10C 10, 0.7 power 10, 10 minus 10, that is 1, 0.3 power 0. So when you calculate each term, I've written term wise here, so this term will be simplified to 0.2334 plus this term will be simplified to 0.1210, and this term will give the numerical value 0.0282. So when you add these three quantities, you get 0.3826. So therefore, probability that at least 8 seeds germinate is 0.3826. Next, find the probability that at most 8 seeds germinate. So probability that at most 8 seeds germinate is probability of R less than or equal to 8. At most means less than or equal to, at least greater than or equal to. So P of R less than or equal to 8. So here we can take less than or equal to 8 means we need to calculate from P0 to P8. So there will be more number of terms. In such cases, we need to use complement property. So that is equal to complement of this is 1 minus P of R strictly greater than 8. Strictly greater than 8 means 8 is missed here. We cannot consider 8. Next value is 9 and 10. So you get 1 minus probability of R strictly greater than 8 can be written as 1 minus P of 9 plus P of 10. So we will be calculating only these two probabilities. So whereas in the case, if we consider the calculation directly, P of R less than or equal to 8 will be P of 0 plus P of 1 plus P of 2, etc., etc., up to P of 8. So many terms will be there. So it takes time to compute. So in such cases, we have to use the complement property and write it conveniently as complement of this correctly. So complement of probability of R less than or equal to 8 is 1 minus probability of R greater than 8. So that will be only two terms here, because only 10, n is equal to 10 here. So after 8, 9, after 9, 10, only 9 and 10 will come, because R is strictly greater than 8, 8 is excluded, not included. So P of 9, so already we have determined here, P of 9, second term, so 0.1210, P of 10 also we have determined, 0.0282. So when we simplify this, we get 0.8508. So probability that at most 8 seeds germinate is 0.8508. Okay, my next question is, determine the probability of getting 9 exactly twice in 3 throws with a pair of dice. Determine the probability of getting 9 exactly twice in 3 throws with a pair of dice. When a pair of dice is thrown, we get 36 possible outcomes or cases. Therefore, the exhaustive number of cases is 36. Favorable to the happening of 9 in a throw of a pair of dice is 6, 3, 36, 4, 5, 5, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are four cases favoring to the happening of the sum 9. Sum 9. Okay. So therefore, favorable number of cases is 1, 2, 3, 4. So the probability, required probability P is equal to 4 by 36 is equal to 1 by 9. So therefore, you can calculate Q. Q is equal to 1 minus P, that is 1 minus 1 by 9, 9 minus 1, 8, so 8 by 9, and 3 throws, 3 throws, so N is equal to 3. So we know the parameter N, and we know the parameter P, so P and N are known, so therefore you can write the probability mass function of binomial distribution as P of X is equal to R is equal to NCR P power R into Q power N minus R. So replacing N by 3, P by 1 by 9, Q by 8 by 9, we get the probability distribution function for this problem as P of R is equal to 3CR 1 by 9 power R 8 by 9 power 3 minus R. So the question, probability of getting 9 exactly twice, that means R is equal to 2, R is equal to 2. The probability of getting 9 exactly twice in 3 throws with a pair of dice is probability of R is equal to 2 is equal to replace R by 2, 3C2, 1 by 9 square, 8 by 9 power 3 minus, that is 1. So when you calculate, you get the numerical value 0.0329. So therefore, probability of getting 9 exactly twice in 3 throws with a pair of dice is 0.0329. Okay, my next question. Determine the binomial distribution for which mean is equal to twice the variance and mean plus variance is equal to 3. Also find probability of x less than or equal to 3. Determine the binomial distribution for which mean is twice the variance and mean plus variance is 3. So we need to calculate probability distribution, that is probability mass function for the binomial distribution for this problem. That means we need to find the two parameters N and P for this problem from these sentences, these equations. Mean is twice variance, and another equation, mean plus variance is equal to 3. Let us consider mean x1, variance x2. Let x1 be mean and x2 be variance. So it is given that mean is equal to twice the variance. So mean x1 is twice the variance 2x2. Mean plus variance is equal to 3. That is x1 plus x2, mean plus variance is equal to 3. So let us solve these two equations as a simultaneous equations in two unknowns, x1 and x2. We obtain very easily x1 is equal to 2 and x2 is equal to 1. That is mean is equal to 2, variance is equal to 1. So mean is equal to 2, that means NP, mean of the probability binomial distribution is N into P, variance of binomial distribution is N into P into Q. Therefore, mean is 2 means N into P is equal to 2, variance is 1 means N into P into Q is equal to 1. So call this as equation 1, equation 2. Using 1 in 2, that means NP is equal to 2, Q is 1 by 2. Using 1 in 2, Q is 1 by 2. So P is equal to, since P plus Q is equal to 1, P is 1 minus Q. So 1 minus 1 by 2 will be equal to 1 by 2. So P is 1 by 2, Q is also 1 by 2, N is, substitute here, P is 1 by 2, so N by 2 is equal to 2, so N is equal to 4. So we got the two parameters by solving, by considering these two equations and making use of the relations, mean is NP, variance is NPQ. So we got the value of N. So two parameters, P is known and N is also known. So therefore, we can construct the probability mass function for the binomial distribution. P of X is equal to R is equal to NCR P power R Q power N minus R. So replace N by 4, P by 1 by 2, Q by 1 by 2. So and N by 4. So 4CR 1 by 2 power R 1 by 2 power 4 minus R. So you can simplify this. So this is equal to 4CR 1 by 2 power R plus 4 minus R. RR you can cancel because of difference in sign. So you get 4CR into 1 by 2 power 4. Okay, so this is the probability mass function for the binomial distribution of this problem. Also find, so we have determined the binomial distribution. Now we have to find P of X less than or equal to 3. So P of R, X is equal to R, so therefore R less than or equal to 3 is P of 0 plus P of 1 plus P of 2 plus P of 3. Here also we can make use of complement property, that is 1 minus R greater than 3, so you get only one term. Anyway, in each case 1 by 2 power 4 is common, so that can be removed. 1 by 2 power 4 into this is 4C0 plus 4C1 from P of 2, this is written outside, 4C2. Similarly, when R is 3, 4C3. So when you calculate, this will reduce to 15 by 16 and its numerical value is 0.9375. Our next question is the probability that a pen manufactured by a company will be defective is 0.1 if 12 such pens are selected at random. Find the probability that 1. Exactly 2 pens will be defective, at most 2 pens will be defective, at least 2 pens will be defective, none will be defective. So here also the probability of a pen will be defective is given to be 0.1. So this is a probability, so we can take this as the p is equal to 0.1, and 12 such pens are selected at random, so therefore this is our another parameter, n is 12. So P is 0.1, N is 12. So we can write the probability mass function P of X is equal to R, NCR, P power R, Q power N minus R. So since P is given to be 0.1, Q can be calculated as 1 minus P is equal to 1 minus 0.1 is 0.9 and N is 12. So probability mass function of binomial distribution is this. Substituting for N and R, we get P of R is equal to 12CR 0.1 power R, Q is 0.9, 0.9 power 12 minus R. Question number 1. Find the probability that exactly 2 pens will be defective. That means R is equal to 2. Probability of exactly 2 pens will be defective is P of R is equal to 2. So when you substitute R is equal to 2, you get 12C2 0.1 square 0.9, 12 minus 2, that is 10. So when you simplify, you get 0.23. So probability of exactly 2 pens will be defective is 0.23. Similarly, probability of at most 2 pens will be defective. That is the next question. at most 2 pence, means less than or equal to. Probability of at most 2 pence will be defective is probability of r less than or equal to 2, that this is equal to p of 0 plus p probability of 1 plus probability of 2, 2 defective, 1 defective, 0 defective. So this is equal to 12 c naught 0.140, 0.94, 12 minus 0, and plus replace r by 1, 12 c 1, 0.141, 0.94, 12 minus r, r is 1, minus 1, plus when r is 2, 12 c 2, 0.1 square, 0.9 power, 12 minus 2. So this is individually, if you calculate, this term will give the numerical value 0.2824, the second term will reduce to 0.3765, third term will be the numerical value 0.2301. So when you simplify, you get add all the three quantities, you get 0.8891. therefore, the probability of at most 2 pence will be defective is 0.8891. third problem, at least 2 pence will be defective. Probability of at least 2 pence will be defective is probability of r greater than or equal to 2. At least means greater than or equal to. So you can use the complement property here for our convenience. A quick calculation, 1 minus probability of x is equal to r, so this r only, x is equal to r less than 2. So we can change here. Or less than 2. So its complement, 1 minus p of r less than 2. So this is equal to 1 minus p of 0 plus p of 1. So 1 minus, when you put r is equal to 0, you get 12 c naught 0.140, 0.9412. When r is 1, 12 c 1, 0.141. 0.94, 12 minus 1, that is 11. So when you simplify individually, you get 1 minus from this term 0.2824 plus from this term 0.3765. So this will give you the value 0.3409. The probability of at least 2 pence will be defective is 0.3409. Next, probability of none will be defective, that means no defective, all good ones. So r is equal to 0, p of probability of r is equal to 0, that is replace r by 0, you get 12 c naught 0.140, 0.94, 12 minus 0. So this will be simplified to, calculated to 0.2824. so therefore the probability of none will be defective is 0.2824. so I will stop at this point of time, and I'll continue the problems on binomial, and also start another discrete probability distribution in my next class. Thank you.